Juma. I'm a singer-songwriter. I am born again. I love the Lord. I fellowship at Life Church International at Kenya Cinema. I lead worship there. I am a lawyer by profession, but I pursued a certificate and an associate's degree in arts and ministry at a worship school in Tampa, Florida. My experience at Worship Factory was a very expanding experience. And at the time, I had only been singing in places where my dad was preaching. For example, before joining Worship Factory, I never sang soprano. Never. I was an alto. I joined as a soprano. And then I find the likes of Jackie, and I'm just like, why am I doing that? Because what are these? And I remember one time, I can't remember where we were going, but our soprano Jackie was not coming. So I was forced to be the only soprano, which was a bit tasking because I always depended on her being there. Because if I was to sing soprano and she's there, then I'd be, you know, more confident and I kind of hide behind her voice. But I grew, I learned a lot from her. It worked. Now much, much, much better. All these amazing opportunities came, had started coming up. Sinaj, Mary Mary, Don Moin, singing with Mercy. I got so much exposure that I had never experienced before, which was pretty amazing. My prayer for Worship Factory would be that each of them individually and as a group release a sound that is unheard in Nairobi, in Kenya, in Africa, a unique sound that can only come from them. I feel like Worship Factory is a stepping stone for so many people from where they are into the next level and into where their destinies are, their callings are, because I believe it's a training ground for a lot of people, and then you're launched into your calling. My prayer is that they continue to grow with their influence in this area and even expand into other areas. Really, my desire is for them to be seen by the world and for the world to hear what they have to offer. So what I'd say about the music scene in Kenya, something I'd really want everyone to know and to register in their minds, that we should, as a nation, as musicians in Kenya, we should stop trying to be like other people. We've for the longest time tried to do our music, and I may not be speaking for everyone else, but this is just something that I think we've been trying to do our music like so and so, or you know, with that mentality. But instead, I would love to see people just sit down by themselves, close out everything, every other voice, every other sound, and just sit there by themselves with the Lord, with the Holy Ghost, and ask the Lord to give you your own sound. Of course, you draw inspiration from, you know, South Africa, you draw inspiration from the States, from all these places, and that's good. But then again, there's something special about you as an individual that South Africa doesn't have. There's something special about you that the States doesn't have. And we want to hear that. That's what we want to hear. Otherwise, we'd go to South Africa and hear that. Or we'd go to wherever else and hear that. And it's so important because when each of us release what is in the inside of us, then we have such a beautiful array of music and diversity and all that. So I would really encourage each of us to just unlearn what you have learned in the past and just sit by yourself, ask the Holy Spirit to come and just help you release the giftings that are already on the inside of you, and learn what you have learned and just start. Follow me on Instagram @_JumaSheila and on Facebook Sheila Juma, and I have a website www.sheilajuma.co.ke. I have a blog called Marked on there, so go follow, subscribe, everywhere.